Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to solve one important problem from the fourth unit, that is the finite word length effect. So already we solved some problems from the two topic. One is the quantization of filter coefficients, and another one is input quantization error and output quantization error problem we discussed, okay, in the previous four videos. Now we are going to solve the very important problem from this fourth unit. It is a limit cycle oscillation problem. Okay, so you see the question. Explain the characteristics of limit cycle oscillation with respect to the system described by the difference equation y of n equal to q. Here the q is nothing but the quantization process. So the difference equation is simply y of n equal to a into y of n minus 1 plus x of n. Okay, so here the constant A is multiplied with the delayed output. So in this product, okay, here we are performing one product, multiplication we are performing. So in this multiplication process, we are performing the quantization. Okay, so due to this quantization effect, so we have to study what is the characteristics of the limit cycle oscillation in this system. So here, the y of n is the output of the filter. You know, y of n is nothing but in this equation, y of n is the output of the filter. X of n is the input of that particular filter. And this q is said to be quantization process. Okay. And assume here the value of a, okay, this constant a is a equal to 7 divided by 8 and x of 0 equal to 3 by 4. What is x of 0? The input applied to this system at the time n equal to 0. Okay, so we are applying some input, you know, this is the system. So for the system, we are applying the input x of n. At the time n equal to 0, the input applied, it is said to be the x of 0. So the x of 0 value is 3 by 4. Okay, and the x of n is equal to 0 for n greater than 0. That means only at a time n equal to 0, we are applying input to that particular system. Okay, in the remaining time, we are just removing the input. Okay, that is the input applied is 0. Okay, that is the condition given. And choose the 4-bit sign magnitude thing. Okay, so here the quantization. So 4-bit sign magnitude, we have to choose in order to perform the quantization process. So it's a December 2016 question. So similar to this question, you may receive, okay, the first order system means the same equation only. So this problem. So there may be a chance to ask the A value is different and the X of 0 value is different. Okay, so we are going to start the limit cycle oscillation. So in order to solve the problem, first you should know about what is limit cycle oscillation. Okay, so why this limit cycle oscillation error is happening in the particular system. So we are going to discuss, then we have to solve the problem. So the limit cycle oscillations. Okay, so in a recursive system, so always a maximum thing, it is a recursive system. Recursive means the output of that present output of that particular system depends upon present input as well as the past output. Okay, so you see in the given system equation also, you see this is the present output. The present output y of n depends upon present input as well as the past output. What is y of n minus 1? Y of n minus 1 is the previous output. So here the system equation, this system is said to be the recursive system. Recursive means the present output of that system not only depends on present input, it also depends on the past output. Okay, that is a recursive system. So in recursive system, there is one important problem. It is called as a limit cycle oscillation. So in recursive system, when the input is 0 or some non-zero constant value is applied, okay, even the input applied x of n is 0 or constant value is applied to that recursive system, because of the non-linearity produced due to the finite precision arithmetic operation. That is, here we are performing the quantization process. Since the processor is having a limited register in order to store the result. Okay, so that's why, because of this finite word length effect, there is some non-linearity effect is produced in this system. Okay, so that non-linearity, it produces the periodic oscillations in the output. Okay, that means, so you know, if one system is there, means if you are applying some input, that system produces the some corresponding output. Okay, but here we are applying the input is zero. So if input is zero means that system must produce zero output. Okay, but because of this recursive in nature, okay, so recursive means the present output not only depends upon the present input, it depends upon the previous output also. Okay, so due to that nature, even though the input is zero, the system produces some finite output. Okay, some finite output. That output may be one constant value, or it may be switched between the two things. Okay, that is said to be the oscillations. So due to this non-linearity produced in the particular system, because of this recursive in nature, we are getting some minimum output in the system continuously. Okay, so that thing we are calling it as a limit cycle oscillation. So this thing only we are going to prove. Okay, so in this first order system, we are going to study the characteristics of the limit cycle oscillation. Okay, that means only for this system at n equal to zero. Okay, the time n equal to zero only we are applying the input x of zero as a 3/4. Okay, so after that, at n equal to 1, n equal to 2, n equal to 3, we are applying the input is zero. That is, no input is applied. Okay, if that system is a linear system, means the output of the particular system must be zero if you are removing the input. But here, the output of the system is not zero. The output produces some minimum output. Okay, so that output we are going to derive in this problem. Okay, so for that one, so first you just write, so the given difference equation of the system. So this is the equation of our given system. The output y of n equal to quantization of a into y of n minus 1 plus x of n. Okay, so where here the system has only one product. Okay, so here the constant a multiplied with the previous output y of n minus 1. So here there is a only one product is there. So in this product only we are going to quantize. Okay, so if the product is quantized to the finite word length. Okay, so here it is given as we have to choose the 4-bit sign magnitude. So the product value, this a into y of n minus 1, we have to round off it to 4-bit sign magnitude representation. So that time, so what is the limit cycle oscillation we are going to study? Okay, so first one, you just write, so that a quantized output, you just take it as a y dash of n is equal to q of a into y of n minus 1 plus x of n. Okay, so first we are considering at a time n equal to 0. Okay, so we are considering the time n equal to 0. So put n equal to 0 in the above equation. Okay, in our given system equation. So if you are substituting n equal to 0 in the above equation, so you see y dash of 0. So what is y dash means? After quantization, we are getting the output, you know, that output you just consider as a y dash. So y dash of 0 equal to q of a into y of n is 0. Okay, so that's why y of minus 1 and a value. So in our problem, what is the a value given? A is equal to 7/8. So 7/8 into y of minus 1 plus n equal to 0. So if you are substituting n equal to 0, that is a x of 0. Okay, and you know the value of x of 0. So the x of 0 value is also given in our problem. X of 0 is 3/4. So you just substitute x of 0 value. So the quantization of 7/8 into y of minus 1. So what is y of minus 1? That is, y of minus 1 means at a time n equal to minus 1, the output produced by the system. Okay, so in here in our problem, the previous output, all previous output, that is there is no data is given. Okay, so that's why we have to assume it as y of minus 1. Okay, the previous output produced by the system is 0. Okay, so y of minus 1 is 0. So 0 into 7/8, 0. So quantization of 0 plus 3/4. So if you are performing for 0, if you are performing the quantization, we can get the answer 0 only. Okay, so that's why 0 plus 3/4, 3/4. So y dash of 0 equal to 0.75. That is, so y dash of 0 equal to 3/4. So 3/4, it can be written as a 0.75. Okay. So y dash of 0, you just consider. This is the first. Okay. Then at a time n equal to 1. Okay. So you just substitute. So next, the time n equal to 1. So you just substitute n equal to 1 in our given system equation. So if you are substituting n equal to 1, so you see y dash of 1 equal to quantization of a into y of 1 minus 1, 0. So y of 0 plus x of 1. So you see the equation. So y dash of 1 is equal to quantization of that a value, a is 7 by 8 into y of 0 plus x of 1. So here we have to substitute the value of y of 0 and x of 1. So what is y of 0? So y of 0, you just see from the previous step. Okay, at n equal to 0, we are deriving the output of the system. So you see, what is the output? The output of the system at the time n equal to 0 is 0.75. So you substitute this y of 0 value here. So 0.75, it is nothing but a 3 by 4. So quantization of 7 by 8 into 3 by 4 plus x of 1. What is x of 1? At the time n equal to 1, input applied to the system. So you see in our problem, so this is our problem. So here the x of 0 is 3 by 4 and the x of n is 0 for n greater than 0. What is the meaning? The input applied to the system is 0 other than n equal to 0. Okay. So at n equal to 1, n equal to 2, all this thing, the input is 0. So what is the value of x of 1, x of 2, x of 3? It is a 0. So in our problem, the x of 1 value, it is given as a 0. So you substitute x of 1 is equal to 0. Okay. Then you just multiply here 7 by 8 and 3 by 4, you multiply. So we are getting the answer 0.65625. Okay. So for this answer, we have to perform the quantization. So here, what is the, that is, we have to perform 4-bit sine magnitude quantization we have to perform. Okay. So 4-bit sine magnitude. So sine magnitude means, so 1-bit is allotted for, in order to indicate the sign. Okay. It's a positive number or negative number. Then the remaining 3-bit is used to represent the particular decimal number. So here 0.65625 decimal number. So for this decimal number, we are going to perform the 4-bit sine magnitude quantization. So that quantization process we have to done in a separate manner. So you see the quantization process. So in order to perform the quantization process, first this number 0.65625. Okay, it is a decimal number. First, this decimal number we have to convert into binary. Okay, so already you know the procedure in order to convert the decimal number into binary. Okay, so if it is a whole number, means you just divide by 2 and you can write, but this is the fractional number. Okay, so that's why in order to perform the that conversion decimal to binary. So you see here, this is the conversion of decimal to binary. This is our decimal number 0.65625. So this fraction number, you just multiply with 2. Okay, so if you are multiplying, you can get the answer is 1.3125. Okay, so here you keep this one as it is. And again, you take the, except this whole number, you take the remaining part. Okay, remaining fraction number, that is 0.3125, you just take and again multiplied with 2. So you can get 0.625. So in this, the whole value is 0. So again, this value 0.625, you multiply with 2. So you can get 1.25. So in this 1.25, 1 you keep here, 0.25, you again take and multiply with the 2, 0.5 and so on. Okay. So you just do the process. So here, this process, it will end here only. Okay. 0.5 multiplied with the 2, so 1. Okay. So here in this process, you just take it as a this whole value. Okay, so except this fraction, so you take this whole value and this whole value you write from the top to bottom. So the corresponding binary representation for this decimal number is 0.65625. For this decimal number, the corresponding binary is 0.10101. Okay, 0.10101 binary. This is the process in order to convert the fractional decimal number into binary. Okay, so this is the thing. And this binary number you write here. So if you are converting 0.65, you see 0.625, if you are converting into binary, you can get 0.10101. This zero, okay, this is this zero, it indicates the sign. Okay, if it is a positive number, the sign magnitude is zero. If it is a negative number, instead of zero, we have to put one. Okay. So we are converting into binary. And the next one, we have to perform the quantization process. So in our problem, the number of bits used to perform the quantization is given. So here you see, choose 4-bit sign magnitude quantization. Okay, so including sign bit, 4-bit truncation or rounding we have to perform. Okay, so this is the sign bit. So for sign bit, 1 bit you just then remaining 3-bit. Okay, so the quantization we have to perform. So here we are performing the quantization. So 3-bit. So 3-bit you keep here. Then 4th bit. From 4th bit you see. So from the 4th bit you just neglect it. So that's why the quantized to 4-bit including the sign bit answer is 0.101. Okay. This binary number, again, you convert into decimal. Okay. This binary number, you just convert into decimal. So already you know the procedure in order to convert binary to decimal. So if you don't know means, so listen. So in order to convert this binary number into decimal, you see 0.101. Okay. 0.101. If we want to convert into decimal means, so after this decimal point, the first digit, 1, this 1, you should multiply with 2 power minus 1. That is 2 power minus 1 means 1 by 2. Then again, the next digit, 0 multiplied with 2 power minus 2. That is 1 by 4. 1 multiplied with 2 power minus 3. Okay, so you just add these result. So 1 into 2 to the power minus 1, it is 0.5. 0 into anything, 0. So 1 into 2 to the power minus 3 is 0.125. So you just add all these values. So you can get 0.625. So 0.101, it is nothing but the corresponding decimal value is 0.625. Okay. So after performing the quantization process, you just convert into decimal. So if you are converting, you can get the answer 0.625. Okay. So here, so what is the quantization process of? Okay, so here the result, that is this is the Y of 1. Okay, Y of 1, that is output of that recursive system at n equal to 1. It is nothing but a quantization of 0.65625. So the quantization process we calculated separately. So after 4-bit quantization, what is the answer we can get? It is a 0.625. Okay. So after quantization, the 0.65625 is converted into 0.625. So this is the Y dash of 1. Okay. This is at n equal to 1. Similarly, we have to do it for n equal to 2, 3, 4. Okay. So up to which one we have to do means, so the output, this output of the particular system, it remains some constant value. Okay, again and again, the same output it will come. That is said to be the limit cycle oscillation. Okay, so up to that one, we have to derive. So next condition is at n equal to 2. So substitute n equal to 2 in our given system equation. Okay, this is our system equation. So in this equation, put n equal to 2. So if you are substituting n equal to 2, so y dash of 2 equal to, so you see, y dash of 2 equal to quantization of 7 by 8 into y of n minus 1. So 2 minus 1, y of 1 plus x of 2. And you know the value of x of 2. What is x of 2? X of 2 is 0. For the system, only we are giving the input at n equal to 0. For the remaining time, the input is 0. Okay, so x of 2 is 0. And y of 1, what is the y of 1? Just now we derived from the previous step. Okay, so the y of 1 is 0.625. So the quantization of 7 by 8 into 0.625. Okay, so you multiply 7 by 8 into 0.625, you can get 0.546875. Okay, then for this number, we have to perform the quantization process. Okay, 4-bit sign magnitude quantization we have to perform. Okay, so for that decimal number, again the same procedure you have to do. So 0.546875, you just convert into binary. Okay, so already you know the procedure in order to convert the decimal into binary. So you see 0.546875, you multiply with 2. So you can get 1.09375. Okay, so here you keep this whole value as it is. The remaining fraction value you take, again you take and you multiply with 2. You can get 0.1875. And again, this 0.1875 you multiplied with the 2, so 0.375. And again multiplied with the 2, 0.75. 0.75 multiplied with the 2, 1.5, and so on. Okay. So we want only the four digits only. So that's why after that you just neglect it. So from this thing, you just take it this whole part. Okay. So from the top to bottom, you just write. So 0.546875, the corresponding binary number is 0.10001. Okay. So we are converting that number 0.546875 into binary. So this is the answer. Okay. So for this binary value, we have to perform the quantization process. So quantized to 4-bit, including the sign bit. Okay. So the sign bit 0, you just keep as it is. Then the remaining 3-bit you take. Okay. From the 4th bit, you just neglect it. So 0.100. This is after quantization. Then this binary number, you just convert into again decimal. Okay. So 0.100, if you are converting into decimal, means the answer is 0.5. Okay. So already know the procedure. You see 0.10. So 0.10 means, so this one multiplied with the 2^-1, the remaining 0, 0. So 0 multiplied with the 2^-2, 0 multiplied with the 2^-3. All the zero. So the answer is 0.5. Okay. So 0.100, the answer is 0.5. So this number, quantization of 0.54678. After quantization, we can get the answer is 0.5. Okay. 0.5. This is the y′(2). Okay. y′(2). Similarly, we have to do it for n=3. So put n=3 in our given system equation. So y′(3) is equal to quantization of 7/8 into y(2) plus x(3). So this x(3) value is 0. What is y(2)? y(2) just now we derived 0.5. Okay. So 7/8 into 0.5, it is a 0.4375. So for this number, we have to perform the quantization process. Okay. So you see 0.4375. Again, you convert this decimal to binary. Already you know the procedure. You multiply this 0.4375 into 2. Then you keep the whole number. The remaining fractional number you multiply with the 2 and so on. So you can get the answer 0.0111, etc. Okay. Then for this binary number, we have to perform the quantization to 4-bit. Okay. So the sign bit is a 1-bit, except a sign bit. You just take the 3 bits. Okay. So here you see 0, 1, 1. Then the 4th bit, you see 4th bit is 1. Okay. In the previous process, the 4th bit is 0. Okay. So that's why we neglected. Similarly, in this case also, the 4th bit is 0. So neglected. But here you see the 4th bit is 1. So if the 4th bit is 1, means that is we are performing the rounding process. So rounding means you keep this 3 bit as it is. 4th bit, you see 4th bit 0 means you just neglect it. 4th bit 1 means that 1 you have to add in the 3rd bit. So 1+1, you can get 0. Then carry 1, again 1 with the here 0, 1. So 0.100. So after rounding to this including sign bit 4 bit, you can get the answer 0.100. So again, you convert this 0.100 into decimal. So already, you know, in the previous step also 0.100, what is 0.100? It is nothing but a 0.5 decimal number. So y′(3) equal to 0.5. So you note here at n equal to 1, we will get different answer 0.625. At n equal to 2, we can get 0.5. At n equal to 3 also, you can get 0.5. So here you see the same output we can get. Okay. So the limit cycle oscillation started. Okay. So similarly, you just derive it for, if you are deriving for n equal to 4. Okay. N equal to 4 in a same manner, you can get the output is the same 0.5. Similarly, at n equal to 5 also, the output is 0.5 and so on. Okay. So from this, you just conclude this. Okay, so you write this answers in a table. So you see, this is the time n, this is the output produced by the system. Okay, so at n equal to 0, what is the answer we can get? So from the first step, okay, so in first step, you see, at n equal to 0, what is the output? 0.75. At n equal to 1, what is the output? 0.625. Okay, so you write here, you form a table. At n equal to 0, the output is 0.75. At n equal to 1, 0.625. At n equal to 2, 0.5. At n equal to 3, 0.5, 4, 0.5, 5, 0.5, and etc. So after that, the output of this system is the same output we can get because of this limit cycle oscillation. So our system enters into limit cycle when at n equal to 2 and above. Okay, so after this n equal to 2 and above, we can get the same output. Okay, we can get the same output, that is said to be the limit cycle oscillation. So we have to write that. So you see, for from this table, for all values of n, n greater than or equal to 2. Okay, n is 2 and above 2, the output produced by the system is the decimal value 0.5. Okay, hence the output becomes constant for n greater than or equal to 2. So even though the input is 0. Okay, even though the input applied to the system is 0, that is, we are applying input only at a time n equal to 0. Okay, then at n equal to 1, n equal to 2, n equal to 3, after that, the input x of n applied is 0. Even though the input is 0, the system produces some minimum output. Okay, so therefore, the system enters into limit cycle even though the input is 0. Okay, that's why this limit cycle oscillation, we are calling it as a zero input limit cycle oscillation. Okay, so we studied the behavior. And the next thing, we have to derive the dead band. Okay, so in our problem, limit cycle oscillation means automatically we have to derive this dead band. What does dead band means? In a limit cycle, the amplitude of output are confined to a range of values, which is called the dead band. Okay, so some in limited range, only that is 0.5, you can get the answer, you know, that is called it as a dead band. So in order to derive the dead band for first order system, this is the formula. Okay, so for first order system, the dead band is equal to plus or minus 2 to the power minus b divided by 1 minus modulus a. Okay, so here b is nothing but number of bits used to perform the quantization including sign bit. Okay, so here we are using the quantization, you know, 4-bit sign magnitude quantization. Okay, so including sign bit, how many bit we are using? That is the B. And A, this A is nothing but the constant, the filter coefficient. Okay, so in our problem, the system equation given, you know, Y of N equal to, so you see Y of N equal to A into Y of N minus 1. This is A. Okay, this A. So what is the value of A given in our problem? 7/8. Okay, so you see, this is the A value. Okay, A value. So the dead band. So therefore, the dead band is equal to plus or minus 2 to the power minus 4. B value is 4 divided by 1 minus A value is 7/8. Okay, so using CALCI, you just calculate. So the answer is 0.5. So the dead band is, the range of value, the system oscillates the output, it ranges from minus 0.5 to plus 0.5. Okay, minus 0.5 to plus 0.5. Within this range, our system oscillates. That is, call it as a dead band. Okay, so for this limit cycle problem, we have to derive this dead band also. Okay, so this is a very important problem. So similar to this problem, you may get one type of problem from this limit cycle oscillation. So there may be a chances to change the value of A. So A, instead of 7/8, there may be some different values given, and the input applied to the system is also differently they will give, but the procedure is same only. Okay, so thanks for watching my channel, and please subscribe my channel for more videos. If you want to learn all videos related to the subject, digital signal processing, signals and system, in our channel, there is a separate playlist is there. Okay, for the complete course, you just learned using that video. I will give link for that playlist in the description box. Okay, so we will see in the next video with one more limit cycle problem.